I will
but
find
every
this.
Day you mm-hmm. can do something different. It can be big, but mostly a big change or do something very big, that's difficult because then we see a mountain that high. But if you do something small, then we can handle that better. And if you fail that day, then always there is a brand new day to try it again.
Very positive message. Thank you
yes.
for that. And here is the clicker.
Thank you, Pia.
Thank you.
Pia.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I mean,
how has it been since 2014? A lot has happened, I guess.
Yes. It's an amazing journey.
Yeah.
And I never would have imagined what kind of journey it was. And yes, in the past 5 years, I need to say that when I started this journey into an agile way of working, I really didn't know anything about agile.
And you are also, that we should mention that you're also writing a book.
Yes, I left ING already this summer to start my own business, helping other companies in their journey to the agile way of working or to become more agile. It's not only by changing structures, but there's a whole world behind it. And I'm writing my book about the people journey into the transformation.
I'm so curious.
Yes.
Good luck now.
Thank you, Pia.
Yeah.
And thank you for having me here. We met 4 years ago.
Yeah.
And I learned a lot from you.
Thank you.
It was then, by then, it was a short talk, but along the way, I learned more from you. And last year I was here and it was very inspiring for me. And I went to the deep dive session about business agility from Evan. He was here last year. And I'm very excited to be here and to share my story and hopefully to inspire you and help in your journey.
Great. We are eager to listen, aren't we? One more applause for Alice.
Thank you. So what is the nicest thing about the song, A Brand New Day? Because I have a lot of songs that I love. But this song, when I was younger and we went out on Friday and Saturday evening, and this song, they played this song, then everyone jumped on the dance floor. Not one stayed besides. And that's because it's a really inspiring song. And it doesn't matter if I know you, or I know you, or I know you. But if they play this song, then we all dance together. And that's a bit what you want in your organization, isn't it? Because we all have a talent. It doesn't matter if you can dance, but you can do something else. And we have gold in our organizations. But how to kick that cage open? I'm Elise Hofmeester, and I want to introduce myself by my purpose. Gather a team, set up the expedition, sail through the waves, and explore beyond horizons. It's not about discovering new landscapes, but it's about seeing things in a different way. It's about teams and teamwork, collaborating, because I don't believe we can do the things on our own in the future anymore. We need each other. And that's why I am here. I want to help you in your journey. Not by changing all kinds of landscapes, structures, but seeing things in a different way. And how can we make small steps? And if we are a bit blocked by frameworks, or if we are blocked by laws, what can we do within the framework? What can we change to make it a bit more better, a bit more agility, and can do things together? It's also about sharing the story, and that's why I'm here. Why? I think, and that's also why you are here, that the case for business agility is pretty clear. This. The time to volume decreases rapidly. And if you look at this picture, then you see that it took the phone 75 years to reach 50 million people. Can you imagine that? And along the way, we see that the time decreases rapidly. 90 days. One game was faster. Who was it, do you think? Who? We have a lot of IT in here. Who knows? Ah. Mario. 8 days. And 10 years ago, now I think 12 years ago, I got my first iPhone. That's only 12 years ago. Can you imagine that? That you can live without it? No, eh? No, I can't. But the thing is that we know better than the doctor what is happening inside our body because we search for it on the internet. So it becomes far more difficult for every organization to respond fast on the needs of our customers. So we need to change and we need to try new things. We need to come up to speed, how we call that. And can you imagine that maybe in a few years we stay at home, we don't go to this conference, but we stay at home and there is a game, we put on our VR, or maybe we can already become a hologram and we meet each other inside a game. What does that mean for our society? What does that mean for our jobs? What does that mean for ourselves? Because we need to learn, and to learn fast. We need to reskill, and we need to upskill. But where do we come from? We come from this. 100 years ago, we worked in factories, and it worked very well. We split our tasks in small pieces, and everyone knew what he did. We didn't need to think. Because the thinkers, that were the managers, and the managers were there, and we as employees are here. This was invented, and you know it all, I think. And in most organizations, it still looks like this. But we need to do something different. And that cost, you can imagine, that cost time. Because we did 100 years to work, like I showed you before. And yes, of course, along the way, something changed. But not that much in most organizations. And if you look to research from World Economic Forum, then within 4 years, look at this picture. We have 27% new roles in the next years. That doesn't mean that we are able to do all these roles. So we need to learn. We need to use all the intelligence in the organization. But how are we going to do that? Yesterday, it was very funny, I read an article. It was a research from Accenture. And it says that a lot of people, 60% of employees, know of this. They know that they need to change. They know that a lot of new technology is coming in. And they want to embrace it. But another part of this research told that business leaders do not spend more time or more budget on training on skills. So they are not on the same level, business leaders and employees. And if you work in an organization and you know that a lot of things are going to change, then you need to do something. You need to take a lead on this. We all need to do that because we need all people in the organization. So what are most companies do nowadays? We are implementing new structures. The architecture evolves. Maybe you know this one. It's the so-called Spotify model. I don't think Spotify agrees with me, but this is how it is mentioned. We work in squads, we work in tribes, we work in chapters. We also know the circles. And within the circles, we have all kinds of different roles. most of the organizations who work with circles have some functions, but they also work with roles. And you can tell or decide in the team what kind of role you want to do. And after a period you worked in this role, you can give it back and you can change the role. But together you need to do the work. Or this one, the Scrum of Scrums, the team of teams. Or this one, we introduce SAFe. It doesn't look very easy, isn't it? It looks very difficult for me to understand what that means. And in the future, we go there, a networking organization. Bjarte already told what Hire is doing. They work in small groups, small entities. And you really need to read what is written about it, because it's very interesting. And that's our future. Is it? We don't know yet, because it's a bit complex and it's unpredictable. But in these structures, there work people. And people need to know what this means. What does it mean for you if you work in a kind of tribe structure or in a squad structure? Is it the same as you did before, or do you need to do something different? We work in multidisciplinary teams. What does that mean? What is someone of IT doing? What is someone of marketing doing? What is someone of HR doing? And how do we work together to achieve our results or our purpose? You need to explain that. So what do you see when you see this picture? What do you say?
Happiness.
Happiness, yes. Some more. What do you see? Yeah, okay. Yeah, nice.
Freedom.
Freedom, yes. Nice. Water, yes. Something else? Males only. Oh, okay. Yeah. Maybe I need to change that in the picture, but that was not the case. Yeah, sorry, yeah. Fun, yeah. Patterns. Okay, fun, maybe. Energy, flow. And that's what you want to see in an organization, isn't it? We want to have fun and we want to have energy, because it helps us in our way of working. And in all those structures, there work people. And people need to know they don't go from A to B the way we want it. No. People go forward. They go backward. They go up and they go down. And they need help. And why are they doing that? They are doing that because our brains work that way. You can imagine that if you announce a big transformation in your organization and it impacts you personally in your job, in your day-to-day life, and you hear every time, it depends, we're not sure, we need to change, we need to work together in multidisciplinary teams. What happens is in our brains is what we call resistance. But what happens, that is our most oldest brain working from the time that we were hunting, and when there was a bear behind you, then people, they fly, or they freeze, or they fight. And that's normal. So what we need to do together is help people. Show them what the next stages are, and that you are not telling it, but that you want to involve. Because people, we always say people don't want to change, but that's not true, that's not the case. People want to change, but they don't want to be changed. So transformation is a journey, and it impacts our behaviors and our mindset. And we need to do that together. It's not an event that you can do today, hop, we change into a different structure. Go ahead and success. No. We can implement it one day because we have to, But then the change is starting. And then the journey is going on. And yes, in the beginning, we talk about transformation. But what it exactly is, the change is never ending. And we want to achieve a kind of sustainable growth. And we can only do that by doing the things together. So, how, if we have those stretches, how are we starting? We build the house together. 5 years ago, when I was asked in the transformation team, I already told in the beginning, I knew nothing about Agile. And most of our team didn't. And of course, I was very excited because I have a kind of change heart. I worked in the HR department back then. And I started to read a lot of books. And we started to talk about Agile. And we visited some companies, but not a lot of companies were already working in this way of working. And we announced a communication session. It was a big town hall. First for the senior managers, and then for the employees. And yes, there were a lot of questions from the people. You can imagine that, because it's quite a change. And they also asked, and I will never forget that, one of the guys in the room, they said, if you want us to change into self-organizing teams, you want to empower us, and you want us to be end-to-end responsible, why is this communication so top-down? That was something to think about. And we went back to our departments. I went back to the HR department. And communication went back to the communication department. And the board went back to their room. And we thought, no, this is not the way. We need to feel what it is to work in multidisciplinary teams. We need to experiment ourselves. And we need to do this totally different. We need to involve the people and build the house together. So we organized a team, a transformation team, with people from business, with people from data analytics, IT, with people from communication, with people from HR, and with people from facilities. And we started. We started to work in a multidisciplinary team. We started to work with Scrum, and that doesn't necessarily help everyone, because not everyone, if you are in an operations department, then Scrum mostly doesn't work. You need to do something else. But we used this, and we got an Agile coach, and he challenged us on everything. And then he came in, and we thought, oh my God, there he is again. And there was a lot of pressure, of course, because we had just small time to develop new concepts. But it was very good, and I learned from him that you need to have a look on a different way at the things you can do in your organization. Do it small. And another thing is, communicate different. Because you can put everything on the wall. You can say, okay, it's not I, but it's we. It's not about individuals, but it's about the team. It's about helping each other to be successful. It's about curiosity. But what does that really mean? You can put that on the wall. Oh, nice. But that doesn't help you. So what you can do, if you are in this kind of transformations, you can organize sessions with people in your organization. Invite them and help them. And let them help you. Because they know exactly what curiosity means for them. But if I ask that to all of you, I get from all of you a different answer. So you can imagine that if you work in a team and you need to collaborate, what does that really mean? So discuss this in your team. Discuss what it means for you. Discuss what hierarchy is or what it isn't. And discuss in your team and make agreements on that. Because if you, and what you also see in these organizations, we not only work multidisciplinary, but we also work cross-border. So in the future, you work more and more with people from abroad. And they have a totally different view than you have. I have my Dutch view. I have that from my culture, from my education, from my parents, how I grew up, from school, from the organizations where I work. But for example, people who live in Turkey or Spain or in China or in Moscow or wherever, they have a different view. And to understand what helps them in the team and how to collaborate together, you need to discuss these kind of topics. For example, I was in a country in the south of Europe. We discussed about hierarchy. And I know that from the stripes on the shoulder. That's a bit my view about hierarchy, but it's my individual view. I have the stripes, so I can say, you need to do that. But in that country, one of my colleagues, she said, in our country, it's based on respect. We have that not only in our organization, but also in our culture. Because people have the expertise and they are older, and that's how we view hierarchy. It's more about respect, having respect for each other. And that's a different view. And you need to know that and discuss that. It's very interesting to hear. And only that way you can help each other. Inspire and work through purposes. You already heard my purpose. And I'm very happy that I have my purpose. And why? Because my purpose is something that is for me. That's who I am. There's a whole story behind it. I didn't tell you, but that's too long. There's a whole story. It tells what my talents are, where I stand for, when I am getting more happy, what I like to do and what I don't like to do. It's not only about the working life, but it's also about just my life, my family, my friends, my children, my husband, me, who I am. It's totally different than having a function profile. Then I can say, okay, I'm a people and change lead. But what does that say? What does that mean? Nothing about me. But that's the box where we are in our organizations. We have function profiles. And if an organization is able to change that, to work from their purpose, the higher meaning, what do we stand for? Our organization. And if you are able in your organization to have for every department and every team a purpose, then we work on the same things. Then it's not only the HR department, it's not only the IT or the marketing, no. Our multidisciplinary team has a purpose that is aligned with the higher purpose of the organization. And everything we do is challenged by that purpose, so we can prioritize. And if we do something in our team that is not aligned to that purpose, is it urgent? Do we need to do that? No. So then skip it. Because if everything is urgent, nothing is urgent. And it doesn't help your organization, but it certainly doesn't help your customers. And that's where we work for, isn't it? We want to stay relevant, and we want to add value to our customers together within the whole organization. So if you are able to create a purpose through your organization, create a purpose for the people, or your people let them create their own purpose, and you can align them together, then people are working on the things where they are good at and what they like, where they get energy from, and where they have fun, because fun is very important for our brains. Together, we identify constraints, because it is not that way that if we change our structures, if we change our way of working, that we don't have constraints anymore. We have a lot, and we get new ones. But you can identify them together. I don't know if you heard about the elephant roads. Who knows what an elephant road is? If you see elephants, they walk behind each other. The big elephant in front, the small elephants afterwards, and they walk their own road. So if there are fences on the road and they cannot move them away, they go around it. And that's also what people do. So if you change the structures and your way of working, you need to change your way of thinking, your way of communicating. And then all of a sudden, only if there is just one team working in a multidisciplinary way or self-organizing and the rest of the organization isn't, they feel that they get blocked by the processes in the organization. The finance process, like Bjarte already told, they are mostly yearly. But how are the HR processes in your organization? Also yearly? Are they done by the teams, by the people in the organization? Or are they done by the management, the leaders? And how can you change that? For example, a hiring process. In a new organization, are we still doing that only by the leaders? Are they only responsible for hiring? No, they are not. And the people in the teams, they like to hire the new people for their team, for their department, for their organization. So why shouldn't we experiment with that? And I know from experience that people are very capable to do that. And they like it. And they also like to do self-selection. In the beginning of our transformation, we did the selection on behavior. Not on skills, because we knew a lot of people had the skills. But on behavior. And along the way, when people started to work in the new organization, they said, this is not really my function or my role. I want to do something different. And then they started to do their own hiring process. They did a self-selection. And they did it not once, but they did it twice. And they did that by their own. And they are very capable. Everyone is capable. Everyone who is sitting here can do that, isn't it? But we are not used to do that. Because we worked only in our team, on our function, in our department. And now that is changing. And so it's also for the performance. It's not a performance cycle or the yearly performance cycle, but help the teams to enable performance. So if you need coaching or if you need feedback, and I rather like to talk about feed forward, not feedback, because then we only look back. But we need help about the things we did not achieve yet. So I want to talk about feed forward better. What can help you? What can help you? What help other teams to move on? And that's something, if you work within HR and you lead this transformation, and you want to do things different, experiment that with one team. And if it works, then go to other teams and let them inspire each other and help them. Because people will always find their way. And if there is a fence, we go over it. Whether you like it or not, we do it. And that's also in your organization. Maybe you have an example, maybe not. Maybe you have something in your head. I see you smiling. So people always find their way. Another thing is, we talk a lot about leadership. And yes, of course, a lot of things are changing for managers and leaders. And what kind of leader or what kind of role model do you want to be? Do you have that clear in your mind? If you look at this picture, then you see a swarm of starlings. And I like the metaphor of starlings. Because if you look at it in real life, then not once one starling falls down. They start to fly, and they fly. And it's a movement. It's a flow. It gives you also energy. It gives me energy if I look at it. But how are they doing that? I don't know. One starling is looking at the other, and they follow. But they only follow the starlings around them. But this starling, which is followed by him, he follows another one. And so it's going on and going on until the end. And this is, I think, also what you need to do in an organization. You need to view your organization as a whole. So when are you a role model? When are you a leader? Are you a leader because you have a lot of followers? Or are you a leader because you follow? Because you follow the people in your organization and you enable them to do their work. You help them to get rid of the impediments. You don't need to be a manager or a leader in function name. But also in the team, you can be a leader. You can be a role model for others. And if you think, hey, now we have find something that really works well, what do you do with it? Do you share it with other teams? Do you set up a kind of meeting or, like here, a conference, but maybe that's too big in your organization, and share the ideas? Make the shift from control to trust. Do we view our employees as an X or as an I? I don't think there are X people. We have a view of X people. But I don't think there are X people. We only have processes that make them behave like X people. And let's try to change that. Because people are inspired by purpose. They want to do meaningful work. They want to contribute, not only to the organization, but they want to contribute to society. It becomes more and more important. So what can we do in our organization to change that? And to get all the talents in the organization involved. And not only the talents of the talent pool, of the talents of the 9 grids, the talent of the trainees. No. If you know what purpose are for people, then you also know what their talents are. And that's far more than only those small pools. Because everyone is part of the system. Not only the multidisciplinary teams, but also the HR, people team. And maybe in the future, if we work only in multidisciplinary teams, then we talk about the HR expertise and not about departments. Because an employee journey of an employee experience, a people experience, is made by the people in the organization, not by HR alone. The agile coaches, they are part. Leads, sales. We hear more about it this afternoon. Finance, the board, procurement, consultants. If you work with external consultants, invite them in your team. Don't work separately. Invite them. Because only then you are aligned and you know what is happening in the organization. And I know sometimes you need to hire people from abroad, from extern. And that's fine. Because they can help you. But they also need to train you. And because otherwise they go back and you don't know what to do next. Communication, very important. stakeholders, part of it. Support, every support function. Everyone is part of the system. So involve them in your team. And if they are not going to work in a multidisciplinary self-organizing team, that doesn't matter. But they need to know what you need. They need to know how it works. They need to know that a yearly budgeting or a yearly performance cycle don't help enabling the performance. They don't have to work that way, but they need to be able to help the teams and to change the processes so you can do it in a different way that helps you faster. Create the right environment. Probe, sense, and respond. We are not able to analyze everything, so we need to try every day, a brand new day, to try something different. Experiment, see how it works. If it doesn't work, why doesn't it work? And improve. Build communities and co-create together. If you work always with the same team, and you are sitting in a room, you have a meeting every week, then the ideas get stuck. We have echo chambers, because everything we mention is already mentioned before. So I think 2 or 3 years ago, I started to go to roundtable sessions, and I discussed with people from totally different companies what the problems were. And we are not used to do that, because it's a bit scary. And maybe the first time I went to that kind of roundtable, I thought, okay, but if I have a kind of idea, what is he going to do with it in that company? But I can tell you, you cannot copy-paste. Because what works in one team doesn't work necessarily in another team. And what works in one company doesn't necessarily work in another company. Because we have different products, we have different customers, we have different people in our organization, and we do things differently. Our sizes are different. If you copy-paste a structure from a small company to a company which is big, do you think it works the same way? I don't think so. And then you have to adapt it and embrace it in your own organization. Tweak it, change it, learn from it, and improve. Co-create together. And if you go back tomorrow or afterwards to your organization, then share all the information you got today in your organization. Share it with your colleagues. Don't keep it for yourself, but share it. Help each other and make it better. Experiment and learn every day again. Agility is a mindset. And it's a mindset. I thought, when I heard that the first time, I thought, what is that really, a mindset? And I listened to Carol Dweck. I don't know if you know her. Carol Dweck, she teaches especially to children in schools. And she talks about the fixed mindset and the growth mindset. And it's not the case that you have a fixed mindset or you have a growth mindset. No, we all have both. And if things become difficult, then mostly we go back to our fixed mindset and we go back to the things we always did before. And I remember every time, because I have the same, if it's a bit difficult and scary, then I think, oh my God, what am I going to do? And then I think of Pippi Langstrumpf. I think you know her. And she always said, I've never done it, so I think I can do. And if I fail, or if I do not achieve right away the thing I want to achieve, then I try the next day again. And that's what a growth mindset is. So you have gold in your organization. You have talents everywhere. Take the lead. Involve all people. Work from purpose, identify the constraints. Experiment, learn, improve, build communities, and be the role model. Thank you.